knee osteoarthritis can eventually arise after many years of running with excessive mechanical loads to the knee joint. For example, running with a heel strike coupled with a long overstride angle that includes an unbent knee at touchdown are directly related to producing a more intense degree of compressive loads on the knee joint as compared with forefoot strike running. Even worse, wearing thickly cushioned running shoes when heel strike running while landing with an elongated overstride angle may amplify impact and mechanical loading on the knee joint by increasing rotational stress on the knees. When we summon these stressors, structural abnormalities on the knee joint may arise as compared with forefoot strike running, especially in minimalist running shoes. The same holds true when it comes to walking in thickly cushioned running shoes versus walking in minimalist footwear. When you walk, walking with a heel strike is harmless even when you're barefoot. Most habitual barefoot populations walk with a heel strike landing pattern, but tend to run with a forefoot strike landing pattern because you're moving at a much slower pace when you walk. All around impact levels are exceedingly low, where the hydromechanical properties of the heel pad can easily absorb the minor impact when walking with a heel strike landing pattern, even when barefoot. This is why impact-induced degeneration of the foot muscles and the heel pad, or even elsewhere throughout the musculoskeletal system, is very rare when you walk with a heel strike. However, walking in thickly cushioned running shoes long-term may actually put you at a greater risk of knee problems, even severe knee problems like knee osteoarthritis, as compared with walking in minimalist barefoot-like shoes. Evidence of this came from a 2015 study in the journal Clinical Biomechanics, which is linked down below this video in the description box. The researchers examined the effects of zero-drop flexible minimalist running shoes on knee joint loading biomechanics and knee pain improvements in knee osteoarthritis sufferers. The control group wore standard running shoes that were inflexible and thickly cushioned. The experiment lasted 6 months, where the participants were instructed to carry out their everyday activities. The study's results revealed that minimalist footwear had a promising therapeutic effect on knee osteoarthritis, in that one reason for the rapid improvements in osteoarthritic-related knee pain was the minimalist footwear had the main effect of reducing external knee abduction moments by 22% as compared with standard running shoes. A long line of research has found that increases in external knee abduction moments is one of the most dominant risk factors for knee osteoarthritis. Different lines of research over the past few decades have found the same basic conclusion, in that external knee abduction moments was consistently higher in patients with more severe knee osteoarthritis, and that the greater the external knee abduction moments, the faster the progression of knee osteoarthritis. Why is a high external knee abduction moment damaging to the knee joint over time? A high external knee abduction moment indicates prolonged exposure of high compressive loads on the knee joint due to too much inward rotation of the knee joint during the stance phase of walking. Also, in this condition, the ground reaction force, which is a naturally occurring force exerted by the ground when the body contacts it at each step, seems to be multiplied as well. So it's these increases in compressive loading from the constant excessive inward rotation towards the midline of the knee joint, coupled with that producing a greater than normal ground reaction force that accounts for progressive loss of cartilage thickness in the knee joint, and therefore an accelerated rate of knee osteoarthritis progression. But all of this was found to be reducible by minimalist footwear, in that the minimalist footwear group in the study had reduced external knee abduction moments, which resulted in reduced compressive loading and reduced torque on the knee joint because there was improvements in knee angulation during stance of walking, all of which led to sudden improvements in knee osteoarthritis progression. Likewise, the researchers found that knee pain reduction was 2.5 times greater in the minimalist footwear group than in the cushion running shoe group, why were minimalist footwear more effective at doing a better job at improving the mechanical misalignments of the knee responsible for perpetuating knee osteoarthritis. Essentially, the more you can feel the ground with your feet, there's more of a multi-spectra of sensory inputs acting on the sole of the feet. This multi-sensory integration is responsible for prompting faster and stronger responses in motor reflexes found to improve step responses, not just at the foot, but in the joints as well, namely the ankle, knee, and hip joints. In other words, joint mechanics seems to be more controlled and better aligned when there's enhanced sensory activation on the soles of the feet, like you get in minimalist footwear, and the same advantage remains, but is actually much better when you are barefoot, whereas thickly cushioned running shoes have a poor track record for reliably preventing enough mechanical factors from going wrong. And one reason for that is underfoot sensory stimulation is very limited in these shoes, which could make reflexive contributions in securing more stable joint mechanics less effective or less responsive, which is why there are these differences in the way the knee joint moves and angulates when walking and running in thickly cushioned running shoes versus minimalist barefoot-like footwear. Furthermore, the study complements ongoing research showing that minimalist footwear improves motor ability and was found to lower incidences of falls. And I'll be talking about that one in an upcoming video, but overall, this line of research provides very important insights on how improvements in knee joint mechanics during walking may stem from changes in the sensory feedback acting on the bottom of the foot, such that the more you are able to feel the ground more fully with your feet, the more easily activated the reflexes and neuromuscular outputs are that direct joint movements to be more functionally efficient. So I just thought it would be worth noting that this kind of data presents a very fresh take on the benefits of minimalist footwear, in that these types of shoes do more than just strengthen the feet. The heightened sensory input also instantly organizes better management of movements of the knee joint and can be clinically beneficial for safeguarding against knee osteoarthritis and other knee joint related ailments. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to hit the thumbs up button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't already, where you will stay more informed on the benefits of barefooting and minimalist footwear, as well as more informed on forefoot strike running versus heel strike running. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.